Welcome to the channel Maps for Graduates. Today we learn complex integration. But before we start, let us know why we are learning this concept of complex integration. What is the importance of complex integration? So let's begin. One of the important reason is complex integration can evaluate certain real integrals that are not accessible by real integral calculus. And another important reason is complex integration connects with special functions such as gamma function, error function, and you know these functions play important role in physics. I hope you guys are satisfied why it is crucial to study complex integration. So without any further ado, let's start. In complex integration, few terms like simple curves, smooth curves, contours, and simply connected domains will be used repeatedly. So we must have some knowledge about them. So let's start with what is curve. Suppose xt and yt is real valued function and domain of t is interval a comma b. Okay, suppose this is t, this point is a and this point is b, and this vertical axis represent functions of t. So suppose this is function xt and this is yt. Now let's construct complex function using function xt and yt. So z of t is xt plus iota yt. Okay, and this z is complex function. Now let us see function z of t on ergant plane. This is x, this is y, suppose this is point z of a, that means z of a is x of a plus iota y of a. Okay, suppose as the value of t changes, this zt value also changes, and suppose this point is z of b. Okay, and orientation of this curve zt is from za to zb. This is curve z of t. Okay, now let us understand this by taking an example. Suppose function x of t is cos t and function y of t is sin t. Okay, then function z of t will be cos t plus iota sin t. Okay, so you know this is t, and t is from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, suppose this is 0 and this is 2 pi. Okay, so function sin t will be like this, as you know, and function cos t will be like this. This blue curve is sin t and this green curve is cos t, and you know this function z of t will be a unit circle z of t. Okay, I hope you got the idea about the curves. Okay, now this curve zt is said to be simple if for different t1 and t2 z of t1 is not equal to z of t2. Okay, that is curve zt does not cross itself. Okay, now see an example. Suppose this is point Z A, and as t is varying from A to B, curve is going like this, and then this is point Z B, okay, and orientation is from Z A to Z B, okay. So as you can see, at this point curve is intersecting itself, okay. So this curve is not simple. So you can see from point Z A, graph is going like this, and at this point t equals to t1, it reaches point P, okay. Then afterward value of t changes, t1 plus something, and after certain value of t, it again reaches to same point, okay. So after value of t, suppose at point t2, so at t equals to t2, it again reaches to the same point, okay. So you can see here zt1 equals to zt2, that's why it is not simple, okay. So this graph is an example of simple curve, okay. Now let us see what is closed curve. Curve ZT is said to be closed if ZA equals to ZB. Okay. See an example. Suppose this is ZA, okay, and curve is going like this, and again reaches to the same point. So this point will be ZB, okay. Curve goes from this direction to again reaches to the same point, okay. So this is a closed curve, and this curve is also simple. So this curve is also example of simple closed curve, which is also known as Jordan curve, okay. It has a special name known as Jordan curve. Now I have a question for you. Is it a simple closed curve? So your answer should be, it is not a simple closed curve. Okay, why so? Because it has an intersection at this point, okay. So in simple language, definition of simple closed curve or Jordan curve will be, curve ZT does not intersect itself except at the end point, that is A and B. Now let us see what is a smooth curve. A curve C given by Z from interval A, B to complex plane C is called smooth if Z prime t equals to x prime t plus iota y prime t exists. That is, its first derivative exists and is continuous on interval AB. Second, z prime t should not be equal to 0 for any value of t, okay. Then curve ZT is said to be smooth. That means there is a unique tangent at every point on the curve C, okay. If any curve has unique tangent at every point on the curve, then that curve is said to be smooth, okay. See an example. Suppose we have curve ZT, this is ZA, and curve is going in this direction, and it reaches to point z of b. Okay, so you can see at this point t equals to, suppose t1, this is z t1. So you can see at point z t1, it does not have unique tangent. Okay, hence this curve is not smooth. Okay, but it is a piecewise smooth. Okay, so you can see for t from a to t1, suppose this is curve c1 and this is curve c2, then for t from a to t1, curve c1 is smooth. And for t from t1 to b, curve c2 smooth. Okay, so c1 c2 combined is piecewise smooth curve. Now let's come to the another main topic, contour. So basically contour is piecewise finite number of smooth curves joined end to end. See an example. Suppose this is point ZA and curve is going like this. And this is end point ZB. Okay. Suppose this is C1, this is C2, this is C3, this is C4, this is C5, this is C6. Okay, then C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6 combined is a finite number of piecewise smooth curves. Okay, so this is known as contour. So C is contour. Now see another example of contour. This is an example of closed contour. Now let's see a theorem known as Jordan curve theorem. A statement of this theorem is very obvious. Let's see. Suppose we have a simple curve C, then the points on this curve is a boundary points of two distinct domains. First, which is interior of the curve C, which is bounded, and second, which is exterior of the curve C, which is unbounded. What an obvious statement, Jordan bro. Now let's end this video with the definition of simple connected domain. A domain S is said to be simply connected domain if domain interior to any simple closed contour C lies wholly inside S. Okay, let's understand this with few examples. This is simply connected domain because if you take any simple closed contour, then interior to this simple closed contour is also lying inside this region. Okay, so this is simply connected domain. And this one is not simply connected domain because if you take this closed contour, then interior of this contour does not lie inside this region. Okay, hence this is not simple connected domain. See more examples. This is simple connected domain and this one is not simple connected domain. Why so? Because if we take this simple closed contour, then you can see interior of this simple closed contour does not lie inside this region. Okay, hence this is not simple connected domain. A domain that is not simple connected is called multiply connected domain. Okay. Now this video ends here, and I have a quick announcement to make. Those students who are preparing for exams like CSIRNET, GATE, and other MSc entrance examination can buy our complex analysis handwritten notes for a very reasonable price for only rupees 50. This note contains lots of problems and concepts. So if you are interested, you can contact us through this WhatsApp number. Thank you. Thanks for watching.